Leslie Ann Warren started gearing towards a life in show business right off the bat as a child ballerina. Little did she know that Hollywood stardom would arrive on her doorstep in the form of a Cinderella story, literally. The New York-born actress, born in 1946, is the daughter of a nightclub singer, Margo Warren, Naverblow, and a real estate agent, William Warren. Her parents were of Russian Jewish descent. Warren's mother gave up her own entertainment career for marriage and family. Leslie attended New York's professional children's school and eventually studied under Lee Strasberg at his actor's studio, the youngest student to be accepted at the time, age 17. The freckled, talented hopeful gathered musical stage experience in such shows as Bye Bye Birdie, playing swooning teen Kim McAfee. She made her illustrious Broadway debut in 110 in the Shade, the 1963 musical version of The Rainmaker, and won the Most Promising Newcomer Award. She subsequently received the Theatre World Award for her work in the 1965 Toonfest, Drat. The Cat. The attention she received immediately led to her capturing the beguiling title role in the Rodgers and Hammerstein TV musical production of Cinderella, 1965. Although sweet-voiced stardom was certainly hers on a silver platter, she didn't necessarily carry the sweet tooth for it. Her impact as Cinderella led to her signing with the Walt Disney Studio as their principal ingenue. Co-starring in the rather blah musical showcases The Happiest Millionaire, 1967, and the one and only, genuine, original family band, 1968, further convinced her that she needed to nip the saccharine stereotype in the bud if she was to grow as an actress and sustain some type of career longevity. Rebelling against her studio-imposed image, she left Disney determined to pursue roles with more depth, drama, and character. Changing her name temporarily to Leslie Warren, to reinforce her goal, she replaced Barbara Bain in the long-running espionage series Mission Impossible, 1966, in 1970, but the audiences were quite cool in their reception to the new and improved Leslie and didn't buy her as a femme fatale replacement for the cool and aloof Ms. Bain. After only one season, she left the show and sought greener pastures in the TV mini-movie market, playing a wide range of vulnerable neurotics as well as sexy, worldly ladies. She made her mark in such sudsy 1970s material as Love Hate Love, 1971, co-starring Ryan O'Neal, The Legend of Valentino, 1975, The Rags to Riches Story Harold Robbins, 79 Park Avenue, 1977, for which she won a Golden Globe Award. The epic World War II story Pearl, 1978, Betrayal, 1978, and Portrait of a Stripper, 1979. In the early 1980s, Leslie's movie